And it trickles down, you know, our schools are full of illegal aliens as well. Our children are coming home with illegal alien boyfriends, girlfriends. We don't know this until they're involved, and it's just, it affects every aspect of our lives. I've gotten into 3 car accidents by illegal aliens, one of which resulted in a neck surgery 20 years later. But I think all of us are starting to see the impact that this has on us personally and the people we know. And we know that, you know, we have Tim Foley and Daniel Webster and other groups that are citizen border patrol groups. We're not all cut out for that, you know? We're not all cut out to patrol the border, but we need to find what can we do? What can we do individually to have a voice and to fight back? It starts in your city council, it starts at your state capitol, it starts at the town halls, it starts where you're able to challenge the narrative and say, enough is enough, we're not putting up with it.
And it starts with exposing it. People don't know. And, you know, I mean, Patriot Movement AZ is a little bold for some people, what we do. But, you know, we have discovered so much corruption in our city just by going out.
And walking in their
doors. And going in their doors and going in their events. I mean, we can't sneak into an event anymore, you know, but going in and saying, you know, do you understand that this is going on in your backyard? And people don't. They don't get it. And, you know, I mean, our lives get threatened and, you know, we're just 2 women. But, you know, what gets me is they're not undocumented immigrants.
That's right.
They are not.
Right.
And we have had pushback from city council members because we flat say illegal alien. And you know what they call us? White supremacists. Now, our Phoenix City Council members will go, illegal alien doesn't sound nice. But they never correct them on calling us white supremacists. You know, I mean, it's so one-sided, but until you get out there and experience and see it, you don't understand the insidious little ways that it's creeping into our lives and we're being made out to be the bad people. They're not dreamers.
That's right.
Those illegal alien adults are not dreamers.
These were American dreamers.
Right, these right. are dreamers. I have 3 granddaughters. They are dreamers. These are illegal aliens. And like it or not, until they do something to change their own status and do something for themselves, that is what they are. And I urge everybody to stop playing the PC game of undocumented this and undocumented that and call it for what it is. Because we've got to rip off this pretty little mask that they put over it to make it seem innocent and to make us out to be the bad people for wanting Americans. I don't even like America first anymore. I'm like America. This is our nation.
Amen.
This is our country. We are the citizens. We love legal immigrants. Come into this country the right way. Come in and embrace the culture and embrace this. But you have illegal aliens standing out there with a 30-foot blow up of our president in a KKK outfit, and they're throwing their sandals at it. And Jen and I will go up with our live feeds and we'll go up and say, no, you're not going to do this. And, you know, we're just 2 women, but we don't have a problem. We go down to California and fight against sanctuary state, which, you guys, if every single one of us doesn't vote red down the line, we're going to get a sanctuary state here in Arizona. And there are a lot of places where sanctuary is not used, that we're not using the term, but it's absolutely happening. It's absolutely happening. So, you know, whatever it is, wherever you can be.
City council, school board meetings, town halls. Find
on the streets,
and show up.
On the streets, on the sidewalks. When there's a fight for DACA, we met another angel family out fighting DACA in Tucson one day. And, you know, she came out because somebody's finally fighting for these families and for all Americans. For all Americans. I can't let my granddaughters play in my front yard. And I live in the suburbs. I can't leave them out there. I can't. It's not safe. I can't leave them out there for 30 seconds. If I have to run in to use the restroom, I make them go in with me. I cannot leave them outside. It's not safe. Our children deserve to be safe. Our children do not deserve to have to grow up like this, like second-class citizens in their own country. I'm done with it. I'm exhausted and I've had it. So, you know, everybody stand up, drop the PC, let's call it what it is, illegal aliens, it's an invasion, it's not a caravan, and let's support our president and stop it. They're going to call you racist, they're going to call you white supremacist. Who cares? Names are names.
And I just want to leave you with a thought that this is what permanent separation looks like.
Yes.
Right here.
Laura, do you want to talk?
It's not at the border.
Do you want to talk?
When you're separated.
Well, actually,
is it okay if
Laura, we want you to speak. We're going to let Edna have just a couple minutes.
Yeah, I just want to make sure.
Yeah, and then once Edna's done, we're going to have Laura and Fernando up here so that everybody can hear another Angel family story.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
so Edna,
our message from Patriot Movement.
We've got a couple minutes for you, okay?
Our